Hello my dear students, welcome for today's video lecture of Ganit Pravinya. In today's lecture, we are going to learn the multiplication and division of fraction, okay. You know, we are dealing with the fourth chapter fraction, and in this chapter till now, we have learned the many concepts like ascending order, descending order, then equivalent fractions. Also comparison of fraction. After that we have learned addition and subtraction of fraction, of different types of fraction, like when denominators are same, if denominators are not same, in that case how to do addition and subtraction. Also we have learned addition and subtraction of mixed fraction, okay. So similarly, the next two operations we are going to learn today, multiplication and division. Pay attention carefully. It's very easy to multiply and divide the fractions. Okay, process is same everywhere. Pay attention carefully. What is change? Major change between addition subtraction of fraction and multiplication and division of fraction. Just see here, exercise 9, which is based on these two concepts. So we will solve the examples from exercise 9 to understand the multiplication and division of fraction. Okay. See now, open your page, exercise 9, Xerox page, exercise 9, page number 71 it is. See, without computation, write down the GCD of the following pairs of numbers in question number 1 to question number 5. Now this first question, it is based on GCD. GCD means highest, greatest common divisor or highest common factor, okay. Now why this question is given? See, if you remember in the last exercise, exercise 8, before addition and subtraction, the question was find the LCM without computation, without doing any operation, find the LCM. So we found LCM using the ideas, okay, and that was useful in the addition and subtraction. LCM was useful in addition and subtraction to make the denominator same. Similarly, here in multiplication and division, we want HCF, GCD. So this concept is applicable here in the multiplication and division of fraction, okay. So let's understand how to find GCD without doing any method, without going through any method, okay. See here, the first question is 2 and 8, second 5 and 11, third 175 and 25, fourth 18 and 27, and fifth one is, I'll write that afterwards. Now see here, HCF, highest common factor, means such highest factor of 2 and 8, in which table there is 2 also and 8 also. We have to find such highest number in which table there is 2 and 8, means 2 and 8 both are the multiples of that number, okay. Such highest number, that is HCF, we know that. Now here, how to find HCF directly, the HCF of 2 and 8 directly without doing any method, that is prime factorization method or short division method. Without any method we can find HCF of 2 and 8, okay. How to find? C, observe these two numbers, 2 and 8, okay. In these two numbers see the smallest number, which is smaller number 2, correct. Now check that if 2 in table of is there 8? In table of 2 is there 8? Yes, 2 4 is the 8, right. So 8 is in table of 2 and 2 is also in table of 2, correct. When the two numbers are given and we have to find their HCF, highest common factor, at that time see the smaller number between 2, and if the smaller number is in table of see the smaller number, if the greater number is in table of smaller number, then the GCD of 2 2 and 8 is what? 2 itself. Okay? GCD of 2 and 8 is 2. If you want to check, we can check here by prime factorization method. See, 2 is prime, 2, let's find prime factors of 2. 2 is prime number itself, so 2 ones are 2, correct? And 8. 2 fours are 8, 2 twos are 4, 2 ones are 2. Now, if you write prime factors of 2, 2 and 8, 2 into 2 into 2. Common factor is only 1. So, GCD or HCF, GCD of 2 and 8 is only common factors. You know, GCD means multiplication of only common factors. So, there is only one common factor, that is 2. So, GCD of 2 and 8 is 2. So, here, while finding directly without doing this method, out of these two numbers, see the smaller number. If the greater number is in table of smaller number, the greater number is in table of smaller number, then the smaller number is itself the GCD. Okay, so here 8 is in table of 2, so 2 is GCD of 2 and 8. Understood? This is the shortcut without doing any computation, that is operation. See now 5 and 11. 5 and 11. Okay. Now see the smaller number between these two, 5. So is there 11 in table of 5? Not at all. No. So now see this. 5 and 11. Both are prime numbers. Both are prime numbers. Okay. So out of given two numbers, any one number is prime, then their GCD will be, can you guess? GCD of 5 and 11, it will be 1. If any two, out of any two, out of given two numbers, if any one number is prime, then their GCD is 1 only, because there will be no any other common factors except 1. 1 is factor of all numbers, okay? So, when out of 2 any one number is prime, then their GCD will be 1. This is the another trick of finding GCD when any one number is prime. Okay. Now next, 175 and 25. Out of these two, is there any one prime number? No. Now see the smaller number. Smaller number is 25. So, can you tell me, is there 175 in the table of 25? 25 sevens are 25 sevens are 175. If you know table of 25, 7 to the 14 and 3, 17. 175, 25 sevens are 125. That means 175 is in table of 25, right? So GCD of 175 and 25 is 25 itself. 25 itself is the GCD of 175 and 25. Okay, whenever we have to find GCD without doing operation, check the both numbers, check the smaller number. First check whether out of 2 is there any prime number. If any one number is prime, then their GCD is 1. If both numbers are not prime, then see the smaller number. If the greater number is in table of smaller number, that means the smaller number is itself the GCD. Okay. Now 18 and 27. Here see 18 and 27. Is there any one prime number? No. Now see smaller number 18. Is there 27 in table of 18? No. Here also no. So in that case, what to do? We have to find GCD without any operation. So now see, first write that 18 here, smaller number, okay? Okay? Now see, write just the factors of 18. Factors of 18 means the such numbers in which table there is 18. Now 18 is in table of 1, 18 is in table of 2, 18 is in table of 3, 18 is in table of 6. 18 is in table of 9 and 18 is in table of 18 itself. Okay. Now in this factors of 18, find such highest number. Now highest factor of 18 is 18, right? So in table of 18 is the 27? No. Then see the second highest, 9. In table of 9 is the 27? Yes. 9 3 is the 27. Correct? So in table of 9 there is in table of 9 there is 18 also, in table of 9 there is 27 also. So GCD of 18 and 27 is nothing but 9. Now why we started to check from greatest factor? Why didn't we start from smaller? Because we want greatest common divisor or greatest common factor. Okay, so we start from greater side. Understood? In table of 3 also there is 27, but we can't take this 3 because 3 is not greatest common divisor. It is divisor but not greatest. Okay, so 9 is the greatest common divisor of 18 and 27. So it is GCD. Understood? See last one, fifth one. 38 and 19. Okay, see now. 38 and 19. In this, 19 is smaller number. Okay, check whether 38 is in table of 19. Check whether 38 is in table of 19. 19 ones are 19, 19 twos are 38. Correct? That means GCD of 38 and 19 is, see, 19 table there is 38. Okay, and 19 table 19 is also there. 19 ones are 19, 19 twos are 38. So both numbers are in table of 19, so their GCD is 19 itself. Okay. There is one correction. See, I told you out of 2 any one number is prime, then their factor is then their GCD is 1. No, there is little correction. Both numbers should be prime numbers. If both numbers, see here 5 and 11, if both numbers are prime, then their GCD is 1. Okay, this thing keep it in mind. Both numbers we want prime numbers, then only their GCD will be 1, because see here 19 is prime, but 38 and the GCD of 38 and 19 is 19. Pause this video, write this in your notebook. Okay, this concept we are going to use while doing multiplication and division of fractions. See now, question number find the following products in question number 6 to question number 10. Find the following products. Products means multiplication. So see, question number 6 is 5 upon 8 into 1 upon 2, 7, 11 upon 3 into 2 upon 5, 8, 7 upon 8 into 16 upon 3, 9, 18 upon 27 into 17 upon 18 upon 17 into 17 upon 27. Okay, and 10th one, 72 upon 19 into 38 upon 24. Okay, now see here, multiplication of fraction. Before learning these steps or method of doing multiplication of fraction, let us revise the method of addition, and then I'll tell you what is difference between addition of fraction and multiplication of fraction. See, in addition we added only numerators, we can add only numerators. Another thing is that when we can add numerators, when their denominators are same, then only we can add the fractions. If the denominators of the fractions are not same, then we cannot add. So before that, we will make their denominator same by finding LCM. okay, and then we will add the numerators. Whatever new numerators we will get after making denominator same, those new numerators we will add. Okay, so this was the part of addition and subtraction of fraction. But in multiplication, see, in multiplication we multiply numerator with numerator and denominator with denominator. Here in multiplication we can multiply numerator with numerator and denominator with denominator. Okay, actually multiplication and division of fractions go together, walk together I will say, because in the multiplication there is division also. How it is that you will come to know later. So multiplication and division are not two separate part of the operations of the fraction, they walk together. Okay, because you know why, when we write anything, as I told you before, finding while learning the concept reduce term, small, finding smallest term, we know that when you write anything 4 out of 8, the meaning of this is 4 divided by 8. The meaning of this is 4 divided by 8. So 4 by 8, each fraction is itself, there is division. In each fraction there is division. 4, 5 upon 8 means 5 divided by 8. 1 upon 2 means 1 divided by 2. 11 upon 3 means 11 divided by 3 also. Okay. So whenever we are going to do multiplication of fraction, the division is itself present there. Okay. How to, when we are going to do that, I will tell you. Now see, first see the multiplication, process of multiplication. We have to multiply numerator with numerator. Numerator, we have to multiply with numerator. And denominator, we have to multiply with denominator. Okay? Numerator, we have to multiply with numerator and denominator with denominator. Understood? After that, what we after that, when to use division, that I'll tell you. Now see, in the first fraction, 5 upon 8 into 1 upon 2, these two fractions are there and we have to do their multiplication. So in the first fraction, the numerator is 5 multiplied by, in the second fraction, numerator is 1 upon denominator 8 into 2. 8 into 2, okay? 5 upon 8, 2s are 16. Now 5 upon 16, this is the answer. Now here we are going to use division. First we will check whether this numerator and denominator are in any same table or same number as we have done in the reduced term. While finding the reduced fraction, reduced term of the fraction, if you remember, we divided both numerator and denominator by same number. So we will check whether the 5 and 16 are in any common table. No, they are not in any common table. So this is only the final answer. So here we cannot divide. If possible, then only we will divide. Okay. Here we cannot divide. So 5 upon 16 is the answer itself. Second, 11 upon 3 into 2 upon 5. So multiply numerator with numerator, 11 into 2 upon 3 into 5. Now 11 2s are 22, 5 3s are 15. So 22 and 15, are they divisible by any common number? Are they in table of any same number, 22 and 15? No. Finish. So this is only your answer. Isn't it easy? Multiplication? Yes. Initially it is very easy. After that its difficulty level will increase. So according to that we have to cope up with. Okay. Now see. 7 upon 8 into 16 upon 3. 7 upon 8. Sorry. 7 multiply with 16. And 8 multiply with 3. Now see here, 7 into 16. In the numerator, now there is 7 and 16. And in the denominator, there is 8 and 3. Now here, before multiplying, check
whether any numerator, now two numerators are there, 7 and 16, and two denominators are there, 8 and 3. Check whether any numerator is divisible by any denominator. Any numerator is in table of any denominator, or any denominator is in table of any numerator. Is it there? Observe carefully, is it there, sir, any numerator which is in table of any denominator or which is divisible by any denominator? See this 16. 16 is in table of which of the denominator, 8 or 3? 8, correct? So 16 is divisible by 8. See, 16 is divisible by 8. Now 16 and 8, both are in table of which same number? 8, right? So 16 divided by 8 and 8 divided by 8. What we will get? 8 ones are 8, 8 twos are 16, and 8 ones are 8. Correct? 8 ones are 8. So what we will get? 2 upon 1. Okay, so we are going to do this directly here. When we will divide 8 by 8, 8 ones are 8 and 8 twos are 16. We have divided 16 by 8, we got 2 answer. We divided 8 by 8, we got 1. Okay, so we have now 7 multiplied by 2, not 16. 16 we have divided by 8, so we got 2 here. 7 multiplied by 2, 7 twos are 14. And 3 multiplied by 1, 3 ones are 3. 14 upon 3. Okay, so this is our answer. Further, 14 and 3 are any same table? Are 14 and 3 in any same table? No. So this is our final answer. Okay. Next, 18 upon 17 into 17 upon 27. Now see here. 18 is the numerator, multiply with the second numerator 17 upon 17, multiply with the denominator 27. Now think, check whether any numerator is in table of any denominator, or any numerator and denominator are in any same table. Can you guess? See this, 17 and 17 are in which same table? 17 itself. So let's divide this both 17 and 17 by 17. 17 divided by 17, 17 ones are 17. And this 17 divided by 17, 17 ones are 17, correct? 18 and 27 are in which same table? 18 and 27, are they in any same table? Yes, they are. Which? 9, correct? So let's divide 18 by 9. 18 divided by 9, what you will get? 9, twos are 18. And 27 divided by 9, what you will get? 27 divided by 9, 9. 3s are 27. Understood what we have done here? First, the 17 and 17 are in table of 17. So we divided both 17 by 17. 17 ones are 17, 17 ones are 17. After that, we check that 18 and 27 are also in same table, table of 9. So we divided both 18 and 27 by 9. 18 divided by 9, 2. And 27 divided by 9, 3. Okay? Now multiply the new numerators and new denominators. Here 2 and 1. 2 multiplied by 1, 2. And 1 multiplied by 3, 3. 2 upon 3 is the final answer. Okay? Then see, 72 into 38. 72 into 38. And 19 multiplied with 24. Now before multiplying, check that whether any numerator is in table of any denominator, or any numerator and denominator are in any same table. See first 38 and 19. For this your table must be perfect, okay? So I am taking your table practice. 38 and 19 are in which same table? 19, correct? So 38 and 19 are in table of 19. Let's divide 38 by 19. 38 divided by 19. What you will get? 19 ones are 19. 19 twos are 38. 19 twos are 38. and this 19 divided by 19, 19 ones are 19. Okay, we have to divide both numerator and denominator by that same number, not only numerator or not only denominator. If we are dividing numerator, then we have to divide denominator also. This is the rule of fraction. Then 72 and 24 are in which same table? They are also in same table, which is that 24. Let's divide both 72 and 24 by same number. If when we divide this 24 by 24, we will get 1. 24 ones are 24 and 24 threes are 72. Okay. So now we have new numerators 3 and 2. 3 multiply by 2. 3 twos are 6 and 1 multiply by 1, 1. So 6 upon 1, that means 6 itself. Every number has denominator 1. If the denominator is 1, then need not to write. Okay. So in this way, we have to multiply and divide the fractions. Okay. Here, see, once again, I repeat, multiplication and division go hand in hand. And when we are going to deal with the fraction, multiplication and division go hand in hand, means go together. Understood? Understand this process. Okay. After that, we will see next. See now. Next, perform the indicated division in question number 11 to question number 15. Okay. Now, there is division of fraction. But in division of fraction, there is multiplication. How? I'll tell you. It's very interesting. Seven upon two divided by 3 upon 2. Then 12th one, 3 upon 5 divided by 4 upon 5. 13th, 1 divided by 2 by 5. 14th, 7 whole 2 by 5 divided by 2 whole 7 by 15. And 15th, 17 divided by 6 divided by 3. Okay, see now here. Now the sign is given division, that means there is division. But in the second step, again it will change into multiplication. So I told you, multiplication and division of fraction go hand in hand. Okay, they are very close friends. Now see, 7 upon 2 divided by 3 upon 2. Now when there is division of fraction, 7 upon 2 is divided by 3 upon 2. Okay. So what to do, how to divide? Directly we cannot divide it. Directly we cannot divide, because in multiplication we have seen, when there is multiplication, we divided numerator and denominators. Okay. Same here we are going to do, but first, this division we will change into multiplication. This division we will change into multiplication. How? First fraction write as it is. 7 by 2. Write as it is. And this division we have to change into multiplication. So instead of division, I will write multiplication. Instead of division, write multiplication. Understood? So now see, we have changed the sign. We have changed division sign into multiplication. That means something there will be change in the second fraction. We cannot write as it is down, right? Because we have changed division sign into multiplication, that means something we have to change. What we are going to do? We are going to do reverse this. 3 upon 2 is there. This denominator will bring up and numerator will take down. Okay, it is also called reciprocal of this 3 by 2, that is, we will write it as a 2 by 3. What we have done? What changes we have done here in this fraction and in this fraction? There was 3 by 2, here there is 2 by 3. Denominator we have taken up, numerator we have taken in the denominator. Understood? This change you have to do when you will change the division sign into multiplication. Division divide by 3 by 2 means multiply by 2 by 3. Divide by 3 by 2, that means multiplication by 2 upon 3. Okay, this is the first step in the division, when there is division of fraction, we have to change into multiplication and we have to write reciprocal of the second fraction. Reciprocal means ulta. Denominator will go up and numerator will come down. Okay. After that, now this is the form of multiplication only. We have done in previous question. When we multiply numerator with numerator and denominator with denominator. Correct? Now, in this step, what we will do? Check any numerator and denominator are in any same table. Which two? Yes, this 2 and 2. This numerator 2 and denominator 2 are in same table. Which? 2 itself. So let's divide these 2 by 2. 2 ones are 2 and these 2 ones are 2. Finish. 7 into 1, 7 and 3 into 1, 3. 7 by 3 is your answer. Okay? Next. See next, again same, first fraction write as it is 3 by 3 divide 3 upon 5 divide by 4 upon 5. First fraction write as it is, division sign change into multiplication, and when division sign will change into multiplication, second fraction will be reversed, that is denominator will go up and numerator will come down. There was 4 upon 5, now there is 5 upon 4. Okay, this is reciprocal of this. Now numerator with numerator, denominator multiply with denominator. Again check whether any numerator and denominator are in any same table. Yes, 5 and 5 are in table of 5. So 5 ones are 5, 5 ones are 5. Okay, now 3 into 1 is 3. And 4 into 1 is 4. 3 upon 4 is your answer. Okay. Next, 1 divided by 2 upon 1, 5. Now see, this 1 means not only 1, it has denominator 1. So write it as it is, 1 upon 1, divide, change into multiplication, and write reciprocal of second fraction. That is 5 will go up, 2 will come down. Okay. Multiply numerator with numerator, 1 into 5, and denominator with denominator, 1 into 2. Is there any numerator and denominator divisible by same number? This 1, but they are divisible by 1 only, so answer will come 1 only. Okay, so directly multiply, 5 ones are 5, 2 ones are 2, 5 by 2. Understood? Next. Now this is mixed fraction. So whenever there is a mixed fraction, as we have done in addition and subtraction, what we done in addition and subtraction, first we converted mixed fraction into improper fraction, and after that we add or subtract it. Here also same, first this mixed fraction we will convert into improper. We know how to convert. 7 whole 2 by 5, how to convert into improper? Whole multiply by denominator plus numerator, that is 7 multiply by 5. 7 multiply by 5 plus 2 upon 5 divide by, first write this as it is division, 2 whole multiply by denominator plus 7 numerator upon denominator. Okay, so 7 5s are 35, 35 plus 2, 37 upon 5 divide by 15 2s are 30 plus 7, again 37 upon 15. Now this came in our this form. Okay. Now first fraction write as it is, instead of division write multiplication, and next fraction how it will change? Denominator will go up, numerator will come down, that is reciprocal. Multiply numerator with numerator and denominator with denominator. Now check any numerator denominator are in same table. Both are. See, 37 and 37 are in table of 37 itself. 37 ones are 37, 37 ones are 37. And 5 and 15 are in table of 5. So 5 divided by 5, 5 ones are 5. 15 divided by 5, 5 threes are 15. So now new numerators are 3 and 1. 3 1 multiplied by 1, 3. And 1 multiplied by 1, 1. So 3 upon 1 is 3 itself. okay? 15th one you have to solve by yourself. 617 upon 6 divided by 3 upon 1. So division change into multiplication, this 1 will go up. When there is only 3, that means it has denominator 1. Remember this, okay? Watch this video again and again, then you will understand this. If you have any problem, watch again, understand the process, method, it's very easy, interesting. Okay? So thank you for today and have a nice day.